Morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Why are you saging?
Well, I'm gonna do a reading here today.
Ah, we're back to doing readings in the house.
Well, I kind of feel like the house is back to somewhat normal.
I'm happy that Teresa's able to read people out of the home. That's where she feels most comfortable. Who's ever coming here, this is like a special occasion for them. They get to see the unveiling of the new home.
Do you know who I'm reading today?
Who?
Remember when I went to Florida, that girl, Talia, and she was dying of cancer, and I went there to see her? I'm reading her mom and her sister today. They came all the way from Florida.
Oh my God, wow.
Talia was a 13-year-old girl who was battling cancer for over 6 years. She became an internet sensation from her hospital bed with over 1 million followers. She just had this incredible way of inspiring people. Talia apparently made a bucket list, and I was on it. And I literally dropped everything to meet her. But 22 minutes after my plane took off, Talia had passed away.
When's your reading? When's she coming?
In a few minutes.
Oh.
I'm gonna sage, finish to set up, and then that's it. Now you have to make yourself scarce.
Yeah, I know. What else is new?
All right, bye. Love you.
Love you too.
Okay.
I'm excited.
Yeah, very excited.
Me too.
I'm also nervous too.
My name's Mattia. This is my mom, Desiree, and we came all the way from Florida to have a private reading with Teresa.
Hi, how are you?
Oh, I'm really excited to see Teresa and have her connect us with Talia again because we really need that reassurance that she's okay and that we're doing the right things that she wanted us to do and keep her legacy alive.
I want to thank you for coming. Your daughter and your sister, I feel her with me every day. I didn't have the opportunity to meet her physically, but as large as her presence was here in the physical world, is just as amazing and strong on the other side. She talks about all the amazing things that are being done in memory of her. She makes me feel like that you guys don't stop. You guys don't stop. She showed me balloons, butterflies, and lanterns. Those are all my symbols for when somebody releases something in memory of someone. Did you do all three?
We did balloons at her funeral. At one of the cancer walks, we opened up an envelope and there was butterflies and they flew out.
And my friend Jill actually lit some lanterns for her too, as well.
Wrote Tally on it, right?
Yes.
Yeah, and they floated up.
Yeah.
Lanterns, yeah.
She talks about the angel wings. So do you have the angel wings? Oh. Did you, is that new?
Yes.
She said that they were given to you.
Her friend's mother at her tribute.
So know that when they were presented to you in memory of her, know that her soul was present. Did you used to say to her, I love you to the moon and back?
I uploaded a picture the other day, and I said, I love you to the moon and back.
Oh my God.
She was my sister, and she was very vibrant. She lit up a room everywhere she went.
I knew Talia was special when the day she was born. But when Talia was 7 years old, she was diagnosed with a childhood cancer.
She wanted me to tell you she still doesn't have hair on the other side. She said, God asked her, she says, I don't want it. Mm-hmm. That would be her?
Yes.
Like she, because she keeps stepping forward and showing me the side of her head with has all makeup and design on it. So that was her. That's how she wanted to be remembered, correct?
Yes.
There was a tumor that started in her adrenal gland and it metastasized up to her chest. You know, it was hard, of course, you know, she lost her hair, she lost her eyebrows, and makeup was a way for her to feel pretty, to highlight her eyes or her cheekbones, her lips. It actually took off the attention from her being bald. And I think the more she got into it, the more she found out she was really good at it.
The lips are very bronzy and maroon kind of color, and then the eyes are just dramatic, and they have green and gold in them. I put some gold for childhood cancer awareness month.
She made me feel like that she was able to teach and touch so many lives. She said to me, she goes, Theresa, I did this all from a hospital bed and a laptop.
Yeah, she did. She started uploading her makeup videos and it just went viral.
I am beautiful.
And I think it was infectious. I think her personality was infectious and it just spread all over the world. The world, I believe, was just looking at this girl like fighting cancer. Yet she had such a positive outlook on life. And she just kept going no matter what.
You don't need hair to be a supermodel or pretty. Bald is beautiful and we can all make bald beautiful.
She knew she wanted to make the world aware of childhood cancer and inspire other people. I mean, there were so many people throughout the world that she touched.
She says nobody knows how to handle when you are told that your child is sick. Were you actually laying with her when she died? And did you tell her that it was okay to let go?
I did.
She wants to thank you for that. Because she said to me, she goes, Theresa, she says, I accepted my illness. And she says, and I want you to know, Mom, that I am okay.
The day that she passed, when it actually happens, you're not ready. It was hard, I mean, to watch your child take her last breath. It's hard.
She makes me feel that you've gotten a lot of opportunities to continue her work.
She left it all for us to continue.
Yeah. Yeah.
She did.
She started it. So.
Yes.
But amazing.
To continue, yes. She had a phone and a laptop, and she was able to spread the word throughout the whole entire world with just those tools. And so now she's left it for us.
She does not want you to question anything. You understand that? But there's a reason why she must be saying that. Does that make sense to you?
What I'm scared about is because Talia was so talented. Even though she was such a tiny girl, she had such big feet to fill. I just don't know if I can do it.
She knows how hard it is for you. And that some days it seems like it's getting harder instead of easier.
Yes.
Now, is there something with her makeup line? You're continuing with the makeup line?
Yes, we're gonna do her own makeup line.
Yeah.
Perfect. Because she goes, I know it's not an easy thing to do. She says, I want to thank you for doing that.
She left such a big presence here on Earth, and she has accomplished so much in such a small amount of time. And I just want to feel like I can fulfill those. Theresa said, you will be able to do it. It's okay. And that's Talia talking. That's what Talia would say.
She says, I want you to stop beating yourself up. She says, Mom, let go of those fears. There are no fears.
That's what she would say, yes.
She is such an amazing and beautiful soul, your sister. There is not a day that goes by that I do not think of her. She is definitely someone that has made a mark in so many people's lives, and most certainly mine. She says, do you wonder what I do in heaven?
Yes, yes.
She is the greeter of the children's souls that pass, and she makes them feel beautiful.
Knowing that Talia sees me and my mom doing all these things for her that she wanted us to do for her legacy, you know, we feel like she's leading us to these things. And I vow to always, you know, keep her legacy alive and to keep her name out there forever.
Thank you so much.
Oh, you're very welcome.
Talia lives on and her legacy lives on, and quite amazing and very comforting to know, yeah, she's here with us.